Okay, guys, I'm going to do just a real short little video here, something that I ran across that may be helpful to some of you. Don't know how many actually will attempt to do what I'm doing here. This is actually a frequency counter module out of a Cobra 2000. Okay. And let's see if I can get this to zoom in a little bit before you guys can see if I can get it to do it and actually focus. Look at that. But anyway, I'm doing this 2000 for a customer, and I'm recapping the frequency counter module. At this point, I have this cap right here removed, and we're going to flip it over, and I'm going to see if I can locate this on camera and get it zoomed in so that you guys maybe can see what I'm talking about. Probably going to be more of a description kind of thing than it is an actual visual. But anyway, I pulled this cap out, and I don't know if you can see it or not, but right here where this leg went through, and these are double-sided boards, by the way, but where this leg went through, once I melted and removed the solder from this particular connection, if you look, it's just copper colored. There's no solder, no silver there, which is a problem that these 2000 frequency counter module boards encounter quite often. What happens, I don't know why, I don't really understand how, I'm not that technical, but somehow or another, over time, I don't know if it's from the heat expanding and contracting, whatever, but over time, these solder connections will actually, I don't know if air gets under them or if it's just something to do with the copper used or something to do with the solder that's used, what, but the copper will actually start to corrode or oxidize underneath the solder. So you end up with you still have a tight solder connection to the leg, and you can't tell it, but you lose connection between your solder and your trace pad. So when this cap came out, I saw this. So now every cap I remove, I'm going to clean these, flux them, and re-tin the pad so that when we go back with a new cap, we get a good connection. If I put it back the way it is now, there's a 50-50 shot whether it'll actually make connection or not. So I could go to the trouble to recap this whole thing and then put it all back together, put it back in the radio, and my frequency counter not work because of this right here. So anyway, it's pretty simple. You just kind of scratch it clean, fiberglass brush it clean, just a tiny little bit of flux on there, just dab a little bit on, heat it with your iron, then touch some solder to it, and it'll re-tin. The copper will take the solder readily. Then you can go back with your cap, and then when you re-solder that, you'll have a good solid connection that should last for several years to come. Okay, that's it. Enough rambling from me. Catch you later. Red Eagle, we out of here.